Hello and welcome guys. Today I'm going to show you how to compile and run C and C++ programs using Eclipse IDE. So for that purpose, we first need to install a compiler. For Windows, the compiler will be minGW64. Just search for it in Google and go for the SourceForge link, which is the fast link. Then you can just click the download button and it will download the online installer, or you can download it manually by clicking browse all files. Then simply choose the most downloaded. Here the most, but we need the 64-bit. As per your system requirement, you can download the 32-bit version. Then just choose the most downloaded. Here you can see it's the personal builds. Then minGW builds. You can also then the latest version. Obviously, you can also download this online installer. It will install you. Then you can install it easily without waiting for searching everything. You can look, I'm just going for the most downloaded one. Here it's the 32 and 64-bit release, 47 MB. Click over it to download it. The download will be starting soon. Now you can see the folder is downloaded. It's a zip folder. Then just extract it. Now the file is folder is extracted. Just copy it to the appropriate location. For me it's the C drive, and paste it here. So you can see here there is a bin folder, and inside it the C++ and the GCC compiler, G++, the compilers are available, and the GDB is the debugger. This is necessary, just like JDK for the Java. It's required for the C or C++ programming to do in the Eclipse. So it's a large, it's 45 MB to download, but after extracting it became 435 MB something. So let it be copy fast. Now that the folder is copied to C drive, just like the Java path setting, go to the bin folder and right click, copy the address, go to this PC or my computer properties, click advanced system settings, then go to environment variable, then find path, click edit, and then new. Just paste it and press OK. 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 Close it. Now just open your Eclipse IDE. Now you can see the Java IDE is open, but when you click here and go to new and click for the project, you can see there are Java Enterprise Edition, Java EJB, JavaScript, Maven, but no C or C++ project. So now we have to add the IDE for C or C++. So go to the menu bar and click help, then click install new software. So work with here the interface for the Java in the Eclipse, sorry, the C and C++ is called CDT. So you can just type CDT and click add. So if you are having problem, then just open your browser and the type CDT for Eclipse. So you go to the Eclipse CDT, then just click download, and here you can see the link. Click here and just go to the URL bar and copy this. Now open the Eclipse IDE, right click, paste the link here and click add. Name you can give it CDT, press OK. Then it will go to the internet and search for the CDT package. Now you can see here the CDT main features, the C and C++ development tools and the tools for the SDK, the optional features, the support and the parser. If you need, you can install these. So I'm going for all. Just click the check boxes and press next. It will calculate and download the features from the internet. So you have to wait for that according to your internet connection speed. Then just press next. Yes, review it and click next. Accept the license agreement and click finish. Installing the software, it will take some time. So now you can see after the installation, it will ask for the restart. After restarting the IDE, here you can see the C and C++ development is on. Now close the welcome panel. You can see little change in the IDE. Now go to the new file and new, then click on project. Then here you can see C and C++. So now just right click here, go to the new C++ project. So give the project name anything you want. Then I'll just show you some examples. So Hello World C++ ready project. Just finish. So here is the program. Now just we want to compile it. So it's compiled. Now the play button, here you can see it's running. So thank you guys. This is all. Bye. See you next time.